The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "In praying, do not babble like the pagans who think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. This is how you are to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. If you forgive others their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Pakibati din ang katabi natin ng good morning. Beautiful Thursday morning to pray together. And to our online parishioners, thank you also for being with us. Your prayers are with us in this Mass, especially for the healing of the sick members of our family. We are in the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew 5, 6, 7. We are now in chapter 6. What is unique about the Sermon on the Mount is that it's really the pure teaching of Jesus. Matthew lays down before us, if you are to know what Jesus thought and felt and what He taught people about, it is in Matthew 5, 6, and 7. Now, He's teaching His disciples how to pray. Many biblical scholars are saying that the Our Father of Matthew is really more the prayer of the community of Matthew. Pinagsama-sama nila ang mga tinurong panalangin ni Jesus at pinag-isa nila sa panalangin ito. Pero kung meron man daw isang salita na talagang galing mismo kay Jesus na tinuro sa kanyang mga alagad, ito yung unang salita ng Ama namin, Ama. It is only Jesus who would refer to God as Abba. The prophets, they would call to God in terms of other names. But Jesus introduced to us a relationship with God that is more intimate, that He is Abba, that He is Father. This is what is unique about the teaching of Jesus. He tells us that God is a Father. He is not God out there in the universe, or He is not God who is distant from us, or God who does not care about us. Jesus connects us, introduces us to God as an intimate figure in our life. He is a person that is alive, that wants to relate with us and wants to show His love to us. He is a Father. This is the most fundamental relationship that we should establish in our life, to look at God as a Father. More than our human fathers or mothers, we have to establish this fundamental, basic relationship with God as Father. Filial trust and obedience to Him. Because without this, philosophers would say, if we don't have this basic intimate connection with God as Father, our foundation will be very shaky and shallow. We will not have a ground for our being. We will not have anyone to cling to, especially in moments of desperation and moments of need. We cannot cling to our human relationships. At the end of it all, there is one ground of our being which we stand on. We cannot cling to anything in this world because all of these things are passing and temporary. Even family relationships, they end. But God, as a father, this is fundamental because He is both the ground we stand on and the future we hold on. Siya yung tinutuntungan natin at siya yung kinakapitan natin. Kung wala siya at kung wala tayong ganong malalim na kaugnayan sa Kanya, malulunod tayo, maliligaw tayo, mawawalan tayo ng pag-asa. Sa mga may karamdaman, maaari tayong pagalingin ng doktor, oo, ng medisina, ng operasyon, ng ospital, ng pangangalaga ng mga nakapaligid sa atin. Yes, they can be instruments of healing for us. But at the end of it all, what really heals a person is that filial trust in God. I trust in You, Lord. You are the author of my life. So I surrender all to You. You know better than me. When I surrender my life, myself, my entire being, my whole life to God as a Father, a God who cares for me, who will never abandon me, I am assured that I will not go down to the pit of darkness or despair, that I will always have someone to cling to no matter what. That's fatherhood of God. At the end of it all, I cling to God as a father who cares for his children. Mawala ng lahat, pero ang pagkapit ko sa Diyos ay hindi dapat mawala. Kasi siya yung babangon sa akin, siya yung hahawak ng kamay ko, at siya yung magbibigay sa akin ng mga salitang magsasabi sa akin. Anak kita, huwag ka mag-alala, hindi kita pababayaan, hindi ka mag-iisa, I am with you. God is Father, He cares for us. Kahapon po ay galing ako ng Coron, ang mga pari po, I think, na-chismis na sa inyo at na-marites na sa inyo. Kami po mga pari ng Maynila ay nagpunta sa Coron for a short fellowship. Pagbalik ko po kahapon, ang Coron po, maliliit lang yung eroplano. Mga 60-seater or even less. Nakapropeller po yung eroplano. Ang problema namin kahapon, maulap, hindi makapasok yung eroplano sa runway. Sinisipat ng piloto, hindi siya makapasok. Kaya umiikot-ikot muna kami. Nakikita mo kasi maliit lang yung eroplano. Tapos mamaya, magta-turbulence ng pagkalakas-lakas, umahagis-hagis yung eroplano. At isa na lang ang panalangin ko, Lord, sana magaling yung piloto namin. Kasi kung hindi, walang magmimisa bukas sa Goretti. Ang hirap po na nasa eroplano ka na parang niyuyugyug ng turbulence. Tapos paikot-ikot yung piloto mo kasi hindi niya makita yung runway. Ipagkakatiwala mo na lang sa piloto mo na, Lord, sana magaling yung pilot. Kasi kung hindi, pare-pareho kaming pupulutin sa Manila Bay. You can only entrust. Wala kang magawa eh, nakastrap ka sa upuan mo. Hindi ka naman pwedeng tumayo, magwala doon. Ang kagawin mo na lang, manalangin na, Lord, sana alam ng piloto kung anong ginagawa niya. That's what you mean by filial trust. Lord, you know what you're doing. I entrust everything to you. You are my Father. May sakit ako, Lord, pero I entrust everything to you. You are my Father. Hindi ko alam kung anong gagawin ko ngayon sa buhay ko, Lord, pero you are my Father. You know everything. You know better than me. I can only entrust to you. Pag malakas yung turbulence ng buhay mo na niyuyugyug ka to the core of your life, you can only say, Lord, sana alam mo yung ginagawa mo. Wala akong magawa dito eh. Naka-seatbelt on eh. Maraming beses sa buhay natin, wala tayong magawa. Pero sa totoo lang, meron. Meron at meron. Kapag may mga pagkakataon na sinasabi mo na, wala na akong magawa eh, meron. Ang magtiwala. At sasabihin mo sa Kanya, wala akong magawa, pero ikaw meron. Father, our Father, my Father, you are in heaven, but you are also in me, taking care of me. We pray to our Father, Father God, Abba, take care of me, take care of my family. I entrust everything to you. You know better. Praised be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Let us pray. O God, who bestowed on Maria Goretti a crown among the saints for her twofold triumph of virginity and martyrdom, grant, we pray, through the power of this sacrament, that bravely overcoming every evil, we may attain the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalo sa ating banal na misa ngayong maga. To our online parishioners, thank you for praying with us. After po our Mass, we will have a healing prayer through the relics of Santa Maria Goretti and San Ezequiel Moreno. And Sister Flora, our prayer partner in the healing ministry, would also like to pray for you. No? You may approach her also after the relic. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our loving God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.